Okay, we're looking at Java Symbol Solver. It's an open source project. What this project does is it lets us look at code from different sources, Java code, and it analyzes it so that we can pull out different parts of it. What this lets us do is this lets us find relationships between different parts of the code. For example, if you were calling a method in one line of code, it would let you know where in the code it was calling in. And so what we're looking at is that I did a change to this project so that now in a lot of the places you would get the qualified name. So this is basically a unique name that lets us identify a piece of the code. And we needed to get the class and the package name separately. We couldn't get this from the qualified name directly. So I wanted to add the class name and get package name so that we can access these. So to add these, I had to add this to one of the interfaces that all of these different Java, some of these different Java parser classes inherit from. So I added it to type declaration because that's where get qualified name is. And since I thought class name and package name were based on that, I put it in type declaration. And so there's a lot of different classes that inherit from this. There's different Java parser classes.
But also places where the package and class name don't make sense, such as in type parameters.
So these didn't end up getting implemented. So now I feel like I should have implemented it only for reference type declaration. As you can see, reference type declaration extends type declaration. And these are reference type is anything that inherits from like a Java object. And but if I show you type parameter declaration, it's basically if you're using generics, and the it says in the comment here, if you had an extend e extend string, the e would be the type parameter. And these don't really have package names and class names because they're we don't really know that what their type is. It's not well defined. And the reason we wanted to use this symbol solver is so that we can find the relationships between different parts of the code in our project. It would be right now, I'm looking at type parameter declaration, and if I wanted to see every class that implemented this interface, I can't do that right now. But we wanted to add that so that I could click on this class and it would highlight all the different places that implemented this interface as one example of what we would use this for. I want to show the feature that this video has been talking about, and this is that we want to show the references to other things in the code. And right now we're doing method calls. So I'm going to go into this helper class, and we're going to see that get package name is called inside container name, and get class name is also called inside container name. And so you look at container name, and you can see that it's used here. It's not finding all of the calls right now, but so far it's definitely been able to find a few of the calls. So we're still working on fixing it so that we can find everything. Here's another class we can look at, and here we'll see solve type is deprecated, but you can see that it's called in two other methods inside this class. It's also called by itself, so that means it's recursive. You can see it lighting itself up. Here we have two reference type. Another, there's a private method, and it's called in get superclass, get interfaces, and get ancestors. You'll see, and we got two reference type. See, two reference type and two reference type. So, yeah. really hoping to get this working with all the calls.